and the evils of our actions, whomsoever Allah guide, let her in this way. And whomsoever this way and can guide, I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship except Allah alone with no partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is his servant messenger. O you who believe in Allah, fear Allah in the way you should be feared, and I let accept the state of Islam with full and complete submission to Allah. O you mankind, be thankful to your Lord who created you from a single person, that is Adam alayhi salam, and from him he created his wife, and from both of them he created men and men women. Be thankful to your Lord from whom you are the most rights. Keep that relationship with your religion, especially with the friendship that Allah is ever worthy of you, all you who believe in Allah. Fear Allah, say the truth, he will rectify your deeds, and he will forgive your sins, and whosoever obeys Allah and his messenger will achieve a great achievement. The best of the speech is the speech of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and the best of guidance is the guidance of our beloved Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most of actions are the newly invented matters of Islam. Where every newly invented matter of Islam is a deviation, and every deviation is misguidance, and every misguidance will lead to the fight. To proceed, my brothers and sisters in Islam, Allah Azza wa Jalla, there is no nation except He has sent a messenger amongst them. And the duty of the messengers was to convey the message of Allah Azza wa Jalla to the people. And Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned this in the Quran. وَلَقَدْ بَعَثْنَا فِي كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ رَسُولًا أَنَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَ الْقَالُ. We have sent in every nation a messenger that to worship Allah Azza wa Jalla and abstain from the taghut, anything which is being worshipped, or anything which is debased, or anything which is equal or equivalent to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, or people they think it as equivalent or equal to Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Allah Azza wa Jalla commands us to abstain from worshipping the taghut. And Allah has mentioned from him that Allah. Some amongst them that Allah has guided, and some amongst them that they are misguided. And Allah has mentioned about the consequence of the people who denies and oppose the message of Allah Ta'ala. And from those messengers of Allah والسلام, the strength of belief to give you an understanding the difference between a prophet and a messenger. Because many of us we think is that the same or something like that, and none of us will have this conception. Anyone who gets prophecy from Allah Ta'ala, revelation from Allah Ta'ala, is a prophet. But the messenger are those ones who are sent to the disbeliever calling them to Allah Ta'ala, those are considered to be messengers. And there is a hadith that even those who are scholars, they said, has some issues. But yet, the understanding of the hadith is quite accurate. That the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said that the numbers of the Prophets of Allah are 124,000 Prophets. And from amongst them, 313, 14 up to 19 messengers. And he said, I am sort of khalq al kathir. A lot of Prophets and messengers of Allah alayhi wa sallam. So the messengers are better than the Prophets of Allah alayhi wa sallam. And the best of the messengers are the five strong will, ulul azmi min ar-rusul. Those are Nuh alayhi salam, Ibrahim alayhi salatu wassalam, Musa alayhi salatu wassalam, and Isa alayhi salatu wassalam, and Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. Those are the five who they are called ulul azmi, the strong will amongst the Prophet and messengers of Allah. And the best amongst those five are Ibrahim and Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the best of the best sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Now, Isa alayhi wa sallam from those prophets and messengers. And we are talking about him today, not because of the celebration of the birth according to them. Not because of this. And we know if people, they get the habit of doing something on a certain occasion every single time, that we come like a religion in Islam. So that's why we're not doing this, but we need to remove misconception. And in fact, if you want to go through the history, and if you go to the facts in the Quran, that Isa alayhi salam wasn't born in the winter even. He was born in the summer. And we know the ayah, and we will talk about it inshallah, and we know the ayah, when Allah has commanded Maryam alayhi salam, وَرُسُلِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمْعِ النَّقْلَةِ. Isa alayhi salam, that you shake the Lord your heart of the tree, of the palm tree, then you remove the dates from it. And we know, and anyone who knows, that the date is only generally in the summer. And that's Barukah, the time of Barukah. And there are other things that's going to relate to this. We do have that. You know, we can't give the time necessarily to talk about this, even some stories, this is an author books about the birth of Isa alayhi salam. That is definitely was in the summer, was in the loop. Now, to continue, inshallah, that Allah Azza wa Jalla, that Allah Azza wa Jalla has made Isa alayhi salam himself, he was miracle. And we believe as Muslims, we believe in his miracle as well. And Isa alayhi salam, people are divided and related to Isa alayhi salam into three categories. People are divided into related to Isa alayhi salam into three categories. The first category, those who deny the message of Isa alayhi salam. And even who went further, some of them went further, who said that Isa alayhi salam even was born unlawfully. He was born in haram, in zina, waliyahu billah, they call this. Those are part of the Jews who said this. Who said about Isa alayhi salam these things. And they say that was the prophet. So those ones who disbelieve in Isa alayhi salam are considered to be disbelievers in Islam. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned anyone who disbelieves in one of the prophets and has said, Allah disbelieves in all of them, but their message is one. And that message is calling to the path of Allah. The second category of the people related to Isa alayhi salam are those ones who exaggerated Isa alayhi salam and placed him above his status. So instead of saying about him that he is a prophet and a messenger of Allah, they give him further. He's not normal prophet of Allah. They say he's the son of Allah, waliyahu billah. Or some they go further to say that he is Allah. He is the Lord. They say about him in incarnation that he is the Lord in the form of your being. And that those are weak extreme. And yet, those are considered to be disbelievers in Allah Ta'ala, denying the belief in Allah Azza wa Jalla, and they didn't exalt Allah Azza wa Jalla from all of these things that belittled him, things that doesn't befit his majesty and glory, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. We believe in Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And we describe Allah Azza wa Jalla what he has described himself in the Quran, or what he was described in the time of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. That's how we describe Allah Azza wa Jalla. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, from his names and attributes, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, which befits his majesty and glory, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So it doesn't befit his majesty and glory, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, that he has a son. It doesn't befit him. It is an imperfect attribute of Allah, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned this, demolished this in the Quran. And Allah said in the Quran, لَنْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ. He doesn't beget nor he must be put in. Allah Azza wa Jalla doesn't need to have a son. Why do I mean, the need of a son is literally the human nature. We need to have a son in order to take care of us, in order to continue our righteous deed. Many things. Allah Azza wa Jalla doesn't need a son to pardon or to forgive. Allah Azza wa Jalla is able to forgive the humanity just only by saying, كُنْ فَيَكُونُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. So Allah doesn't need a son. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, it doesn't befit him to come in the form of a human being or to mix with his creation. So that's one of the things that people, they say Allah is everywhere. Allah is not everywhere. Allah Azza wa Jalla is above his throne, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, in the way that befits his majesty and glory. And it doesn't befit him that to mix with his creation or to be with them in terms of being physically with them. Allah Azza wa Jalla is above his throne, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's how Allah has mentioned the Quran, Allah and Al-Ashish Khalq. Allah is above his throne, Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. And that's confirming that hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That he said, when he asked the woman about Allah Azza wa Jalla, a slave girl, she said to him, he said, who am I? He said, you are Messenger of Allah. He said, where is Allah? She said, above the throne, Allah is Sana. Above the head, that's Allah Azza wa Jalla. So that's why these things that doesn't befit him, we have related to attributes of Allah, and then we say they are negated attributes of Allah Ta'ala. So it doesn't befit his majesty and glory, or to become a human being, or to have a son, and all these things. Those are negated attributes related to Allah Ta'ala. Now, so that's why the third category of the people are those who believe in Isa alayhi salam, that he is the messenger of Allah Ta'ala, and he was born with no father, with a mother with no father. We believe in his miracle as well. that Allah Azza wa Jalla has created him, and exactly how Allah created Adam. If the people they were against and they were killing it, how come that Isa Islam would have no father? We say Adam had no father and mother, and another as well. And Allah has created him by saying, and he came. That's how Allah created Adam. And exactly, Allah has created Isa alayhi salam from our mother. That's why we call him Isa ibn Maryam. He's the Isa, the son of Mary, the son of Maryam alayhi salam. Who's Maryam? Now, we'll come to the point about Maryam alayhi salam, but before that, those are the very technically related to people about Isa alayhi salam, and those are the random ones, those who follow the path of Allah ta'ala. Those are the one who follows the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who believes in Isa alayhi salam. And Isa alayhi salam, he said, وَبَشِّرْ الْمُرْسِلِينَ أَنَّ يَأْتِيَ مِنْهُمْ مُحَمَّدٌ. Give that tidings that the messenger will be coming after me. It's Muhammad, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has said to you, we believe in his miraculous birth, that was born from our mother, Maryam alayhi salam. And Maryam alayhi salam, that she is a woman. A woman who is a chaste woman, who never been touched by a man in her life. Alayhi salam. And Allah has to Allah Messenger alayhi salatu salam, he said, that kamula min al-rijali kathir, wa lam yakun min al-nisa'i illa arba. Allah has perfected millions and choose the devil from them many messengers. All Allah has perfected four women for our blessing. Four women. Those are Asiya, Zawjah Fir'aun. Asiya, the wife of Fir'aun. The one who believes in Allah Azza wa Jal. And Maryam bint Imran. Maryam bint Imran, the mother of Isa alayhi salam. Wa Khadija bint Khuwayl. Khadija, the wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The first wife of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Wa Fatima bint Muhammad. And Fatima, the daughter of Muhammad alayhi wa sallam. Those are the four perfectly good who Allah has perfected. The perfect woman. Now, Allah Azza wa Jal has made Maryam alayhi salam. She is the one who Allah has described about Maryam. That, look at this. Allah Azza wa Jal has said in the Quran about Maryam alayhi salam. Now, before Maryam alayhi salam, she was born in a family that who are pious people. Allah said to him, the wife of Imran, and he was a pious person, and he had a pious wife. She said, so this woman, she wanted to get something from Allah Azza wa Jalla, the most precious thing in her life. So if she didn't have children until Allah Azza wa Jalla encompassed her with his mercy, that she would pray. And then she said, if Khalat Imran to Imran, رَبِّ إِنِي نَذَرْتُ لَكَ مَا فِي بَطْنِي مُحَرَّمًا. Oh Allah, I give like a vow, whatever in my womb it is for you, to serve you, Muharram. Something for Allah Azza wa Jalla. There is no better sacrifice for Allah Azza wa Jalla more than this. So she said, whatever in my womb it is for you, Allah Azza wa Jalla. Someone to be just only dedicated person for Allah Azza wa Jalla. Nothing else. Then Allah said, فَتَقَبَّلْ مِنِّي. So Allah accepts from me. إِنَّكَ تَسْتَمِعُ عَلَيْهِ. You are the all-hearing, the all-knowing, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. Look, she's giving the precious sacrifice. And yet she's asking Allah Azza wa Jalla to accept from her. And Allah Azza wa Jalla, from his not wisdom, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى, Allah said about it, فَلَمَّا وَضَعَتْهَا قَالَتْ رَبِّي إِنِّي وَضَعْتُهَا أُنثَى. والله أعلم بما وضعت وليس ذكر كلمة شيء سبحان الله لكن ما تقول ما تقول بس يوستيك إذا كذا بيقول some of you be just only worshiping Allah and all his life and then she was kind of wondering that she had a daughter and she said oh Allah I'll give birth to a daughter and Allah knows what she gave birth وليس ذكر كلمة and the boy or the male is not like the female why he's married to And I named him Ben. وَإِنِّي أُعِيذُهَا بِكَ وَذُرِّيَّتَهَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ And I seek with you that you protect her from the close of the devil. Then what Allah says to them, "Ana wa fataqabbalaha rabbuha biqabulin hasan wa anbataha nabatan hasan." Then Allah Azza wa Jal accepted Maryam alayhi salam in a kind way, in a nice way, in a beautiful way. Allah has accepted this from him. Wa anbataha nabatan hasan. Allah made him grow up in a good way, in a pious way. Then Allah continued as well, wa kafalaha zakariya. And no one, even not just only that, Allah Azza wa Jal dedicated a prophet of Allah, Zakariya alayhi salam. He is the one who will be taking care of this pious woman. Look at this, all of this as if Allah Azza wa Jal, from His plan, from His wisdom, tabaraka wa ta'ala, all of these things, this is the environment that Allah Azza wa Jal wanted Isa alayhi salam to be born in this environment. A pious young girl who will sacrifice the only child they have for Allah Ta'ala to be dedicated to worship Allah Azza wa Jal. And Allah Azza wa Jal gave this child that even though she was a woman, and yet this child was grow up as a pious and better and a better person. That she grew up in a good way, in a beautiful way, in the best way, in the best form. And then, not just that, and Allah Azza wa Jal has made the Khaliyya alayhi salam to be the one who will be taking care of him, wa kafalaha zakariya. Now, before all that they said, when this child was born, that the people, the children of Israel, that you could say the elite, the one who are the knowledgeable one, they said, who's going to take care of him? All of them. Then they know a lot. Which one amongst them will be the one who's taking care of Maryam alayhi salam? And it was said, whenever they will draw a lot, in every time Zakariya alayhi salam will be the one who's taking care of him. And then they accepted that Zakariya alayhi salam, Allah has mentioned in the Quran about this fact that when they were drawing a lot, who's going to be taking care of Maryam alayhi salam? And Allah has made Zakariya alayhi salam is the one, a prophet of Allah. And they said, part of that, each prophet of Allah, they have general duties. The general duties is to teach the children of Israel the revelation of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, and part of his duties as well is to take care of Maryam alayhi salam. Part of his duties. Now Allah says, وَكَفَلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. Now Zakariya alayhi salam, كُلَّمَا دَخَلَ عَلَيْهَا زَكَرِيَّا الْمِحْرَابِ وَجَلَ عِنَّهَا رِزْقًا. Whenever he comes, the mihrab, and the mihrab is a place, not like people, they call this mihrab, by the way. Yeah. This is not the mihrab, in terms of the language. The mihrab is literally a place dedicated to worship, just to be a person alone, instead of just worshiping Allah, a place to worship, we say musalla. Yeah. So that Zakariya alayhi salam, he had a place that he used to worship Allah, and in that place, and when Maryam alayhi salam, when he was taking care of Allah, he put Maryam in that place. Maryam was literally dedicated their life to worship Allah. Whenever the Zakariya will come to her, and then he will find the rizq sustained from Allah. It was said that the fruit of the summer, she will have the fruit of the summer in the winter. And the fruit of the winter, she will have it in the summer. And then Zakariya will be wonder, will say to her, وَجَلَعَنْ قَالَ يَا مُنُّهَنَّ لَكِهَا. Oh man, what did he do this for? Now look at this, even though she's a child. And she's still young. And yet she will answer, قَالَ فُرُمْ لِذِلَّهِ. This is from Allah Ta'ala. يَنْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِهِ الْإِسَى. He sustained whoever he wished without even accountability. Without even counting. He will give Tabarak wa Ta'ala. So this is the rizq in the hand of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. And from their karamat, from the karamat that Allah has honored Maryam alayhi salam. Look at this. Then the angels used to come to speak to her directly. If قالت الملائكة يا مريم إن الله اصطفاك وطهرك واصطفاك على نساء العالمين. The angels would speak to her directly. Oh Maryam, Allah has favored you and chosen you. And Allah has purified you and chosen you from the women of the earth. يا مريم اقنوت الى ربك واسجدي واركعي مع الراكعين. Even though you are favored in the sight of Allah عز وجل, even though you are honored in the sight of Allah عز وجل, even though you are purified by Allah تبارك وتعالى, yet you are only a slave of Allah and a servant of Allah. That's why Allah says in the Quran about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Subhanallah, asra bi ahlihi min al-masjid al-haram ila al-masjid al-haram. Now, for Allah had a belonging, who made the night journey with his slave. Even he's on earth in the slave of Allah. Even if he was ascended to the heavens, he's the slave of Allah. And he was closer to the throne of Allah ta'ala. And he reached a point that even Jibreel alayhi salam didn't reach that point, yet he is the slave of Allah. So that doesn't mean if someone is elevated amongst the people in the sight of Allah Azza wa Jalla, and if someone Allah has owned a person, it doesn't mean he's not a slave of Allah Azza wa Jalla. All the creation of Allah slaves of Allah ta'ala. So here, if there are money in here, come on yourself to Allah, was judging and prostrating him, or came out of him. And bowed with those who are bowing, those who visit Maryam, alayhi salam. And Allah has said in the Quran, because of all of these qualities, Allah has had all of them conceived in his pregnant with a child in your father. Allah has said in the Quran, O Maryam, ibn Imran, allati ahsanat farjaha. Maryam, the daughter of Imran, the one who chased him by his heart. فَنَفَخْنَا فِيهِ بِرُوحِنَا. That we have blew from our soul, the meaning of our soul here, the meaning of Allah owns the soul. Allah owns the soul, you guys understand, they think Allah has soul, he gives up out of his soul. Allah owns the souls of Allah. And the souls are, it's only Al-Qur. What Allah said in the Quran? For one another. This is from the commandments of Allah, it's from the creation of Allah. So that's why the soul was beyond Allah. So Allah has known the soul of Isa alayhi salam in the womb of Maryam alayhi salam. وَصَدَّقَتْ بِكَلِمَاتِ رَبِّهَا وَكُتُبِهِ. She believes in the words of Allah and in his books. She was from those ones who humbled themselves to Allah ta'ala. Yeah. And the angels came to Maryam. Give me the black timing. Yeah. If قالت الملائكة يا مريم إن الله يبشرك بكلمة من المسلم والمسيح عيسى بن مريم. That the angel will say to Maryam عليه السلام that Allah will give you black timing. That بكلمة من a word from him, which means كن فيكون from Allah تبارك وتعالى. His name is المسيح, the Messiah, عيسى بن مريم. Isa, the son of Mary, وَجِيهًا فِي الدُّنْيَا. He is someone who is honored in this dunya, وَالْآخَرَ عَنْ إِنْدَهَا أَنْ هِرَعْفَ وَمَا مُقَرَّمِينَ. And he is from those who are close to Allah تبارك وتعالى. وَيُكَلِّمُ النَّاسَ فِي الْمَهْدِ وَكَهْلًا. And he will talk to the people. In that, while he is an infant, when he is an infant, even when he is in his corner, وَمِنْ الصَّالِحِينَ from the highest people. And Allah has described this incident, how it takes place in details in Surah Al-Mulk. Now we see this, the amazing thing in the Quran, that we believe that the parents of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they didn't have Islam. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has honored the mother of Isa alayhi wa sallam and made a whole chapter about him. Where there is nothing mentioned in the Quran about the mother of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Look at that children. Allah Azza wa Jalla, this, the link, between all of that is not about the blood lineage. It's about the faith lineage. That's what Allah said upon in the Mu'minun wal Akhwat. Verily, the believers are brothers. So Allah has united us with this, with the faith of Allah. The faith of Allah. Now Allah said in the Quran, وَاذْكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَنْ يَمْرِهِ تَذَذَبْ مِنْ أَهْلِهَا مِكَانَ شَرْقِهِ. Remember in the book that when Maryam alayhi salam, she abstained from the people in east place. Here, so she abstained from the people. فَاتَّخَذَتْ مِنْ دُونِ الْحِجَابِ. And she took like a veil between her, meaning that she was in the direct contact with the people. فَأَسَلْنَا إِلَيْهَا مُحَمَّدٍ. We send him our spirit. Our spirit is Jibreel alayhi salam. Okay, the Holy Spirit, which is Jibreel alayhi salam, or the Qudus, which is Jibreel alayhi salam. فَتَمَثَّلَ لَهَا بَشَرًا صَلِيًّا. And he was in the form of a human being in the front of Maryam alayhi salam. Not here. قال إني أعوذ بالرحمن من إن كنت تقول. I seek refuge in الرحمن, the most merciful one. If you are truly pious person, if you are not pious, you will be a Rahman. happened is the only one who can do can protect me from you. Well, she saw a man. She didn't get a man like this or that. Who that? Then Jibreel alayhi salam said to her, إِنَّمَا نَرْجُلُ رَبِّكِ الْأَهْرَ لَكِ وَنَا بَزِلِ I'm only messenger from your Lord to give you, or to give you as a gift. وَنَا بَزِلِ a purified son. قَالَتْ أَنَّا يَكُنُوا لِكُنَا أَمُرَ وَأَنِي إِسَسْنِي بَشَرَ وَأَنَا كُرْرَهِينَ How am I going to be having a son? And no, if you and me touch me, and I was in someone who was an evil person, an evil doer. Then this angel said, قَالَتَ ذَلِكِ قَالَ رَبِّكُمْ عَلَيْهِ The same way Allah has said this, it's easy on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. وَلِنَجْعَلُ الْآيَةَ لِلنَّاسِ We make him as a sign. As a sign, as a miracle for the people. وَرَحْمَةً مِنَّا And a mercy from us. فَكَانَ أَمْرًا مَقْضِيًّا And it's something that it is something that Allah has already judged. And it happened. By the will of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Then Allah continued. So she conceived this child, and then she went away from the people. Then here, this is what the story. فَأَجَاءَهَا الْمَخَاضُ إِلَى جَبَلِهَا While she was in the site, on the route of the palm tree, then the labor starts happening to her. Here. قَالَتْ يَا لَيْتَنِي مِتُّ قَبْلَ هَذَا وَكُنْتُ مَسْلِمًا I wish I died before this. And someone who's so busy before all of these habits. Now Allah said, فَنَادَاهَا مِنْ تَحْتِهَا Who is the one who calls her? They said, scholars they said, it was Jibreel alayhi salam. And some scholars they said, it was Isa alayhi salam. So because she was called, أَلَّا تَحْزَنِي Don't be sad. قَدْ جَعَلَ رَبُّكَ تَحْتَكِ سَلِيَ Allah has made underneath you like a spring with a spring underneath you. And they said as well, in terms of the miracles of the Quran, they said as well, when women, for example, having, that's why they sometimes they use the running water, they said it will be easier for the women than delivering the babies. They said this. Now, وَهُوْ فِي إِلَيْكِ الْجَلَمَةِ Now, and as will shake the root of the country, تُسَاقُقْ عَلِيْكَ وَقُمَ الْجَلِمِ That is something that you know that we call it, the barota, which is the soft dates. People who know the sukkari dates, you know this soft one, it's like water. So that it will come through frame in your hand, you will eat. Here that shows as well, it is only in the summer. So we are born in the summer, so definitely not in the winter. And as it was said, in their scripture, according to them, that the lambs and the sheep were bred in the field. Yeah. And we know in the winter they don't go to the field. People who have a shepherd in our land are from Jordan, by the way. And Jordan of Palestine, during this time, it's cold. They definitely would not keep the sheep outside during the winter time. So to continue, فَكُلِّ وَشْرَبِي وَقَرْبِي عَيْنِ So eat and drink and let you and have coolness in your heart. فَإِنَّا تَرَيْنِ مِنَ الْأَشْرَحِ So she had concern. What did you going to say about this child? Say, I give a vow to Allah Azza wa Jalla that I'm not So it is part of the fasting the people who fast, to fast even from speech. Like the Prayer alayhi salam, he fasted from speech. And as with Madin alayhi salam, she fasted from the speech. And all of these things was obligated in Islam, and only the fasting which is remained is what we know. The fasting belongs from Allah, or just abstain from food and drink and sexual intimacy from the morning until the evening. So she came. She came with a few regalias. They said, Oh my God, like a dream, she said, you brought something which is shocking. You brought a child. Yeah, after Harun, you sister of Harun. They said Harun was a pious man, and they said this Harun was the brother of Musa alayhi salam. And he was known with his wife. They said, Oh my God, you are the daughter of the sister of Harun. Your father wasn't a bad person. Then she pointed to Ashar to him. They said, she pointed to him. They said, how can you go to someone who is literally thinking? And then here, Isa alayhi salam, said this first word. What's one of the first words of Isa alayhi salam? He said, Inni Abdullah, I'm a slave of Allah. That literally demolished. He didn't say, I'm a son of Allah. He didn't say, I'm Allah. He didn't say nothing of that. He said, I am. The slave of Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala. Give me the book. ودعني النبي أنبئني يا قوم من الله وجعلني مباركا أينما كنت أن نبي بلس ولبلدوه وأوصاني بالصلاة هي أهدي الله ما لي ولفريق والزكاة أتفيد زكاة ما لي تحيي أهدون بلا يدف وبرر بوالدتي أنا قلت مع مرة ولم يجعلني جبارا شقيا يعني تدميكي صلى الله مستعد بإذن تزول تبارك وتعالى والسلام علي يوم ولدت ويوم أموت ويوم أبعث حي أنا فيه أقول مين من الذي أرفوه أن الذي أرفوه إن الذي أرفوه يرزاك This is for as a human being. This is as a human being. And if human will have the day of his birth, will have the day of his death, and will be rejected. And that definitely happens to every single human being. And here, Allah Azza wa Jalla has made it, took care of Isa alayhi salam from the old age. And Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned the Quran. وَجَعَلَ ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمِّهِ آيَةً That Allah Azza wa Jal made the Maryam, the son of Maryam and his mother as a sign to Allah, to the people, as miracle. وَأَوَيْنَاهُمَا إِلَى رَبَّهُ And as we made them to a place, or to a hill, a place, that قَرَالَ مُحِينَ A place that they can settle, and as good a place that they could have their water, they could have their running water there. And it was said, when you saw the debate group, where they were, some of them they said they were in Al-Quds. Some of them they said they were in Beit Lahem, what they called what the police in Quran. Some of them they said in Qasr. So anyway, it is in Sham, in the area of Sham. Here, he grew up, and Allah had to give him the book. And Allah had to, he came to confirm the Torah, which was revealed to Musa alayhi salam. He didn't come to change the teaching of Musa alayhi salam. He continued to teach the teaching of Isa alayhi salam. Except things which was half upon to be practiced, until Allah Azza wa Jalla has left up certain things for the followers of Isa alayhi salam, and to give glad tidings that about the message and the sender will come after him, which is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the message of Islam. Now, Isa alayhi salam, he grew up teaching the teaching of Allah Ta'ala. Whatever Allah commanded him to convey, and he conveyed the message of Allah to the people. Some people believed in him, and some people they denied the believing in him. And they started plotting against him, alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. And he lived on earth for maybe 30 something years. Meaning, and as we believe that he didn't die. Later on, we'll discuss the child and some of the details that Isa will come back as Allah informed us in the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. So Allah has said in the Quran about him, when Isa felt that the disbelief from amongst him, who's going to be my supporters for the sake of Allah? قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله الحواريون the students of Isa عليه السلام they said we are the supporters of Allah عز وجل آمنا بالله we believe in Allah واشهد بأننا مسلمون and this is that we are Muslims we are submitting to the will of Allah تبارك وتعالى and Allah عز وجل has said in the Quran his دعوة وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله إلها واحد they recommended the people of Israel to worship Allah عز وجل as one As one God of Allah, لا إله إلا الله من هو الذي يشرك سبحانه سبحانه عما يشركون ونلقى from all things that they associate with Allah Ta'ala. And Allah has mentioned in the Quran about the message of Isa alayhi salam that I simply to the two main things مصدقا لما بين يديه من التوراة confirming what is taught him before me from the Torah ومبشرا برسول يأتي من بعد اسمه أحمد and even that time of the Messenger that comes after him which is Ahmad And people will say, oh, he's Ahmad, not Muhammad. Muhammad, the one who's praised by the people, and Ahmad is the one who's praised by Allah, and he is Muhammad and he is Ahmad. فهو أحمد أحمد خلقي إلى الله. Meaning he's the most one who's praised by Allah عز وجل, وهو محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, he's the most praising one, تبارك وتعالى, محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ولما جاء عيسى بالبينات, عيسى came with all the signs, with all the proofs. قال قد جئتكم بالحكمة. وَلَوْ أَبَيْنَ لَا لكم بعض الذي تختلفون فيه. And I want to explain to you things that you are, you debate about, that you don't accept among you, you don't agree upon. فاتقوا الله وأطيعون في الله أن أبي لي وأحل لكم بعض الذي حرم عليكم. And I make things lawful to you, things which is to be unlawful before me. So these are obligations. Here, Allah Azza wa Jalla has mentioned about those, the Jews and the Christians and those from the sect. Allah said about them what they have done. And instead of accepting Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala and accepting the message of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala on the tongue of the messengers of Allah said about them in the Quran, اتخذوا أحبارهم وربانهم أربابا. They took their barak, their priest, as Lord of Allah Azza wa Jalla. والمسيح ابن مريم and even مسائل 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 وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله and they were not commanded except to worship Allah على إلها واحدا لا إله إلا هو سبحانه عما يشركون. They were only commanded to worship Allah على الأرض من قال تبارك وتعالى. So they took the rabbis and even Ali ibn Hatim, who was Christian, before he became Muslim, he came to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and said, we didn't worship Allah by some priests. Then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم did not take things which Allah has made it unlawful and they made it lawful for you. And things which Allah has made it lawful for you and they made it unlawful. He said, yes, this is the way that we worship him. Which means they made them as legislators of Allah. And Allah says as well, that is message. Not Sunday with Salah, he commanded you the prayer, was zakat, and pay the charity, as long as I live. So this is the message of Isa alayhi salam. So that's why we need to understand that Isa alayhi salam, he came with a message from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. When Isa alayhi salam, when people start plotting against him, when people start wanting to kill him and wanted to disbelieve in him, and after all of that, Allah says in the Quran, وَإِذْ قَالَ اللَّهُ يَا عِيسَىٰ إِنِّي مُتْوَفِّيكَ وَرَافِعُكَ إِلَيَّ وَمُطَهِّرُكَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا. Allah says in the Quran, O Isa, I'm going to put you in a form of a death. Here, that means the death, that means a form of sleep. The Rafiq, some sort of, they say, the Rafiq, I will give you what you mean, what is your portion of your sustaining this life. This is the truth, this is the end of it at this point. Or, some they said, it is a form of a sleep. And Allah says, confirmed it in the Quran, which is the sleep. Allah is the one who put you like a form of death in the night. Yeah? وَيَعْلَمَ عَدَرْتُمْ نَا and knows what you have done in the day. Now, as they said, and all of these books, it was anything to them that it happened. To some scholars, they said, the one who wrote against the Isa alayhi salam was crucified. Some they said this. At the end of the day, for us, in the letters of the crucifixion, it's only what they clearly mentioned in the scripture. And for us, we don't have to believe that the crucifixion, even if it happened or not, we don't know. But in terms of someone else, I'm not talking about Isa, but definitely for Isa alayhi salam, Allah has left him up before anything happens to him. And he was the Allah had put him in a form of sleep. And as will Barafiraka ilayhi, and that shows and will bring you up to me. That shows Allah is the most high to Barafiraka. And Allah has left up Isa alayhi salam to him. How Allah has known? But definitely Isa alayhi salam, he didn't die, he wasn't crucified. Allah says in the Quran, وَقَوْلُهُمْ when they said about the killing of Isa, they were قَوْلُهُمْ إِنَّا قَتَلَ الْمَسِيحَ عَيْسِنَا and we said, we have killed Isa, the son of Mary, رَسُولَ اللَّهُ مَسِيحَ وَمَا قَتَلُهُ وَمَا صَلَبُهُ وَلَكُمْ شُبِّهَ لَهُمْ. They didn't kill him, they didn't crucify him, but it was imitated him. وَإِنَّا لَذِينَ اخْتَلُوا فِيهِ لَذِي شَكِّرُ مِنْهُ. They still doubt about that. Yeah. And here, مَا لَهُمْ بِهِ مِنْ عِلْمٍ. They have no knowledge. They have no confirmed knowledge. Except following the doubtful matters. Yeah? وَمَا قَتَلُهُ يَقِينًا. And definitely they didn't kill him. But رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ Allah has lifted him up to him, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَزِيزًا حَكِيمًا. Allah is almighty, almighty, تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى. Now, so it was indicated that they thought it happened, regardless how it happened to happen to them, but in the end of the day we know that definitely Isa alayhi salam wasn't crucified. And Allah says in the Quran, they will know some of the people of the book, they will know before the hour, before the day of judgment. They will know that the Messenger of Isa alayhi salam was the truth. And they will know that he was only a prophet and messenger of Allah and the last in the Quran. وَلِمِنْ أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ إِلَّا لِيُؤْمِنَّ بِهِ قَبْلَ مَوْتِهِ وَيَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ يَكُونُ عَلَيْهِمْ شَهِيدًا. From the people of the book, they're going to believe in him as he's a messenger of Allah before his death, the death of Isa alayhi salam. And in the day of judgment, they're going to be a witness against them all in their favor. And Allah says in the Quran, وَإِنَّهُ لَعِلْمٌ لِلسَّاعَةِ. And some, as well, they say, الْعَالِمُ لِلسَّاعَةِ. So maybe there are two riwayat in terms of recitation of the Quran. So he is the knowledge for the hour, or he is a sign for the hour. Here, Allah is about Isa alayhi salam, he is a sign for the hour. So who will be back again? عليه وعلى نبينا الصلاة والسلام. And he will be following the path of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So he will be following and he will rule by the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's why, my brothers and sisters, all of these things are related to Isa alayhi salam. And we have few things, inshallah, at this point about this topic, inshallah. First of all, that the Masihiyah, people, they say Masihiyah nowadays in Arabic language. And by the way, they're both of them, they call it Christianity. The followers of Isa alayhi salam, those are totally different from the Christian. The word don't you know. Even though the Christian of Nodin are not the Kitab, but they are not the followers of Isa alayhi salam, because they claim Isa alayhi salam, he is Allah, or he is the son of Allah, or he is the. The second thing, that the message and the call, the da'wah of Isa alayhi salam, which is Islam, calling to the wrath of Allah, and calling to Tawheed to La ilaha illallah. The third point, that we don't exaggerate, we are Ummat al-Wasta, we are the living. We don't exaggerate Isa alayhi salam to lift him above his status, to make clear that he is Allah, son of Allah. And we don't believe him to say he is like other human beings and he is a son of Allah. We believe his miraculous birth. And believe he is a messenger of Allah. So we are in the middle. And Allah has said in the Quran, in confirming this, says, قُلْ يَا أَهْلَ الْكِتَابِ, all people of the book, لَا تَرُوا فِي دِينِكُمْ, don't accept the dream of faith. وَلَا تَقُلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِلَى الْحَقِّ, and don't talk about Allah except the truth. إِنَّ مَنْ مَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Verily, the Messiah, the Messiah, Isa ibn Maryam, Isa, the son of Mary, he is the messenger of Allah. وَكَلِمَتُهُ, and he is his word, أَلْقَاهَا إِلَى مَرْيَمَ, that he sent it to Mary. وَرُوحٌ مِنْهُ, and spirit from Allah تبارك وتعالى. And as well, and related that, and related to the belief in Isa alayhi salam, that Allah said in the Quran, قَالَ كَذَلِكَ قَالَ رَبُّ مِلِيدٍ to his miraculous birth. We believe in his miraculous birth. And Allah said in the Quran, it's easy upon Allah Azzal, and Allah mentioned in the Quran, إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ. The example of Isa عِنْدَ the side of Allah, exactly the example of Adam alayhi salam. خَلَقَهُ مِنْ تُرَابٍ, he created him from the soil. ثُمَّ قَالَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونَ, Allah said, be, and he became alayhi easy for him to create someone with no father and mother, and easy for him to create someone with no father. Yeah. And as well, some people they say related to Isa that they said, as I said to you, we are in the as a middle woman, and we believe in this in Isa alayhi salam, in the message of Isa alayhi salam. And at the same time, and anyone who says Isa, he is Tariq Talat, he is the third of the three. Yeah, بسم الله الله سيدنا القرآن لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح وعيسى ابن مريم. Yeah. So those ones who say, the disbelief who say Allah is the Messiah, the Messiah, the son of David. وقال المسيح, and the Messiah said, لا بني إسرائيل عبد الله. He said, for worship our worship of Israel. Worship Allah. ربي وربكم. My Lord and your Lord. إنه من يشرك بالله فقد حرم الله عليه وسلم. Whoever associates with Allah, Allah will make prohibit him to enter Jannah. ورواه مالك وذكر ذلك وما للظالمين من انصار. And those who transgress it, they have no support. Then Allah said in the Quran, لقد كفر الذين قالوا ان الله ثالث ثلاث. The one who said Allah is the third of the three, that they disbelieve in Allah. وما من اله الا الله وما من رام من اله الا اله واحد. There is no God except one true God, the Lord of the Lord. Now Allah said in the Quran, وإن لم يكن عما يقول, if they don't follow or if they don't stop what they say, then the more the disbeliever amongst them, we can think that the hellfire, a punishment for the hellfire. And as well, Allah said about Isa alayhi salam, مَنْ مَسِيحُ مِنْ مَرْيَمْ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. Masih, Messiah, Isa ibn Maryam. مَنْ مَسِيحُ مِنْ مَرْيَمْ. The Messiah, the Isa ibn Maryam, he is the Messiah of Allah. he came at a time that there is no prophet or messenger of Allah, wa ummu siddiqa, and his mother is a truthful woman. Can I ask my father? We used to eat the food. You know what we used to eat the food? As human beings, we need food. We need sustain from Allah Ta'ala. Meaning we eat food and they were toilet. That's what it means as well. Yeah. Onlar kefir ve benim namı ayet. Bunu anne yapıyor. Bu şey oluyor. Bu da sayın. And yet, they deny it. So all of these things as well, Allah Azze ve Celle ve kâle Allah ve ya Nisa. Allah says, we ask Isa aleyhi sallam. Ya ey Nisa ibn Maryam, أَأَنْتَ قُلْتَ لِلنَّاسِ اتَّخِذُونِي وَأُمِّي إِلَٰهَيْنِ مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ. Did you say that the people take their mother as daughter of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? And Allah not saying this to know, Allah saying this to confirm this amongst the people. To tell the people in the day of judgment that even Isa alayhi salam will deny this. So Isa, what he would say to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala? Qala subhanahu wa ta'ala, ma lasharika. It doesn't befit me to say something which I have no right to say. In kuntu qultuhu faqad anta. If I know, if I said it, you know it. تعلم ما في نفسي ولا أعلم ما في نفسي. You know what is in myself. And I don't know what's in myself. إنك أنت على غير نور أنسين تبارك وتعالى. ما قلت لهم إلا ما أمرتني. The only thing that I said to them is only what you command me to tell you. أنا عبد الله ربي وربكم. That worship my Allah, my Lord and your Lord. وكنت عليهم شهيدا I went to feel and I was a witness. As long as a witness for them, for against them, as long as I'm amongst them. فلما توفيت المنتخب كنت انت رقيب عليه. You were the one who was watching him. وانت على كل شيء مسير ان يرى مؤنس اقول everything. Then Allah then he knew. The softness of Isa عليه السلام said to him, انت عدل فانه بالعالم. If you punish him, you are those are yourself. وانت اكثر لهم فانك انت العزيز الحكيم. And you pardon him, you are the one who is almighty, all wise, تبارك وتعالى. And related to that, Christmas, and attending Christmas, and people greeting for Christmas. When you greet them with the Christmas, you are greeting them the birth of Allah Ta'ala, or the birth of the Son of Allah Ta'ala. And the people who greet with the Christmas, they are one of the two from the Muslims, one of the two, they're told that. Either they literally believe that to greet them and they believe. Yeah, that Isa alayhi salam was born and he's the son of Allah, etc. He is like him. And he is from there. And like I said, I said, Oh, all the second time, you do not agree with this, and you greet them, you say, you're a poor person. It's a lie. And it's not allowed to lie. You believe it's not the truth. And you believe it's hard. And you believe all of these things that get me greeted. And I remember, and I repeat this, and I remember, sister who said, who a leader who came up to Islam, and she said, can I make dua against the Muslims? I said, how? I said, what are you saying? The brother was talking to her, why are you saying this? Why are you saying this? She said, my parents, they lived and died, and none of the Muslims told them about the truth. And they were coming to our house, and we say, we greet them with the Christmas and all of these things. None of them told them this is wrong. And told them, Ya Allah, shubhika lada Allah Azza wa Jal. And they died, and they lived in Christianity, and they died in Christianity. And I feel oppressed, because the Muslims, they did not convey the message, the true message of Allah alayhi wa sallam. Can I make dua against the Muslims? Allah has had to make dua. Muslims, they are not doing their duties to convey the message of Allah Azza wa Jal. They are not showing the truth of Islam to the people. They are not, that's why, don't be hypocrites. You do read them, and when they come and ask you, tell them, I don't believe in this. I don't believe in that Allah has a son or whatever. In the same time, it doesn't mean that you shouldn't be kind and show them the kindness. You are told us in the Quran. La ilaha illallah, lam yuqatilu fi sabili rabbika wa lam yuqatilu fi sabili rabbika wa lam yuqatilu fi sabili rabbika wa lam yuqatilu fi Allah doesn't forbid you. Those who have been forced to drive you away from your houses. That to be kind to them, to be good to them, to be just with them. Even protect the relation in some sort of, they said, to give them a portion of your wealth as a gift, meaning to buy gifts for them. Allah doesn't prohibit you to do that. So if you have made a straw, then you give them gifts, show them kindness, so, show them softness. Maybe they will accept Islam through this. Or at least when it comes to Christmas, they'll say, our neighbor, our son or daughter who are accepted Islam, they are good to me. They don't need to prove anything for their business. But they're related to give the gifts from them. So don't give them gifts for the Christmas. Don't greet them for the Christmas. If they greet you, thank them. No problem to tell them, because they want to show kindness and explain to them that we don't celebrate Christmas. If they give you gifts, accept it. And Abu Talib رضي الله عنه, he accepted the gift of Nowruz, Nowruz, which is the fire worshiper celebration of it, and he accepted the gift. He didn't give them, he accepted the gift as long as the gift. It has been, which is halal, like chocolate or something, it's fine to accept. Again, with this one with kindness. And even while, no problem if you explain to them why they celebrate Christmas, but thank you for your kindness. So we accept it. So in the day of Eid, you go and send them the same gift, a tribe, to oppose them in a kind way, in a soft way, in a good way. Maybe it will be a way. A way that you call them to Allah Azza wa Jalla. And Allah has said to the Lord, وَقَالُوا تَهَذَا رَحْمَنُ وَلَا. So when you greet them, they say Allah has a son. And Allah has said to them, لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا, you brought something which is great. تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتِ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا. Look at this, that the heaven will crumble, and the earth will crack, and even the mountains will collapse just by saying Ar-Rahman has a wife, to say Allah has a son. And دعوا الرحمن, just before this, Ar-Rahman has a son. وَمَنْ يَبْلَغَ الرَّحْمَنَ يَتَخِرُّ الْوَلَدُ. It doesn't defeat Ar-Rahman to have a son. إِنْ كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا أَتَى الرَّحْمَنِ عَبْدًا. Everything in the heavens and earth, they come to Allah Azza wa Jalla in the day of judgment. You come to Allah as a slave to Allah Azza wa Jalla, submitting to the will, to the universal will of Allah Azza wa Jalla. لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ. And Allah count them and know each one of them. وَكُلُّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. Each of which will come as single, as a soul in the day of judgment. So that's why we cannot say we greet them for what? Say Allah has a son, we have it with that. So that's why my brother and sister, the worst action that you do is to associate to Allah and to do shirk. The worst of the shirk, to claim that Allah has a son, is the worst of the shirk. So these are things which are the points that we need to know. And Allah told us as well to try to spread the message of Islam with kindness and to speak to them. And Allah said, Allah has done with the Ahl al-Kitab illa bi-ladhi ahsan. That speak to the people of the book except in the way which is better, and it's in a nice way. And as when we have our Eid here, alhamdulillah, we need the as some people think, we come for example in the beginning of the year, they say, let's end this year with istighfar. There's nothing. And who told me this? Or let's start our year with fasting. There's nothing of that. Those are bid'ah innovations in Islam. You do specify certain acts of worship in a specific time, except you need to have approval from the Quran and the Sunnah. So we do celebrate the beginning of the year, or end of the year, or New Year, or New Year's Eve. We don't celebrate it. We don't deal with that, and we don't celebrate. And alhamdulillah, we have two Eid al-Adha, Eid al-Fitr, the celebration day for us. And we don't have to do certain things by the end of the year, or the beginning of the year, we have nothing to do with it. And lastly, inshallah, that we as Muslims, we should know that Allah said in the Quran, وَلَنْ تَرْضَ عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَنْ تَصَارَ حَتَى تَتَّبِعَ. That the Jews and the Christians will not keep pleasing you until you go that way. Whatever you do, you try to please them, to greet them, all these things will not be pleasing you until you go that way. You are different from them. That's why you should be proud of Islam, proud of your identity as a Muslim, proud of following the path of Allah and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And that is, if you show kindness to them, they will understand, and they may, Allah will bring them to the truth. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he did not forbid us, actually, he commanded us to be with our neighbors, even if they are not Muslims. And he was the best example, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A woman came to him and she said to him, my brother, she's a mushrik, a pagan. What should I do to her? He said, be good to her, be kind to her, host her, be nice to her. You might be a reason for her to accept Islam. The same thing, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had a neighbor who was a Jew. And one day the Jew, his son was ill, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam went and visited the boy. And he thought to visit a non-Muslim person. So that's why go to the hospital and say, most Muslims or non-Muslims, visit him, no problem if you can go and visit him. Show them your kindness. And then that person, that child, that boy, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, oh Lord, said, testify no one to except Allah and him comes to the Messenger of Allah. The boy looked at his father. He was lying. He was looking at his father. And then he said, then his father, he said, Abay al-Qasim. Obey al-Qasim. Even the father was a Muslim. But he knew that this is the true Messenger of Allah. He said, obey the father of al-Qasim. He didn't say Messenger of Allah because he didn't believe it. He said, obey. Then the boy said, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. He died peaceful. And then the Prophet, he came up and he said, Alhamdulillah, that the Imam of the Imam said, Alhamdulillah, that Allah has saved one soul from me from the hellfire. And that's the Prophet of Allah, alayhi salatu wasalam. So that's why, if we obey them, we never give Islam. If we follow everything, we never give Islam. So we should be proud of Islam. We should be proud of the Sunnah. We should be proud of the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet. To follow the way of Allah and His Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And in that way, inshaAllah, and I will give this example. In the UK, there is between 3 and 5 million. Let's say 5 million, and then officially 3 million, officially, whatever. So let's say 5 million, let's say 3 million Muslims, or 4 million Muslims in the UK. Can you imagine these 4 million Muslims, if they are the same belief of the Sahaba, the same will of the Sahaba, the same strength in the Iman of the Sahaba, how long will it take to convey the message of Islam to every single house in the UK? Month? Maybe weeks? Because we are away from the guidance of Allah Azza wa Jalla. That's what was happening. If there are not, the Sahaba look at them. We were 314, 15, all the way to 19 in the Abu Dhabi. Fiat, the rest of the people. And they changed the face of them. The face of them was Abu Sahaba. The Prophet, he died. When you go to Mecca, there are 10,000 of the Sahaba. And yet Allah has made them to be changed. The whole world of Allah has made. May Allah accept Allah's Sahib. May Allah make us amongst those who accept the Quran and the Sunnah. May Allah make us amongst those who follow the guidance of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. To believe in all the Prophets and Messengers, alayhi salatu wasalam. If you have any questions, inshallah ta'ala, we take the questions, inshallah ta'ala.
For example, your neighbor, I think if you have non-Muslim neighbor, you should make them aware that you are not celebrating Christmas.
Yes.
Of course, you be kind to them all the time, you talk to them.
Yes.
In case if they say to you like Mary, okay, to greet you,
yeah.
I don't feel okay to say thank you. I will avoid that word, or if they repeat it again, I have to explain to them, I'm not celebrating Christmas, and because of this, and this, and this. And they will take it, they will respect you more. And regarding the gift also, so to if you take accept a gift from non-Muslim, especially on this day, if you take the gift and you say to them, thank you, I think that you give them something, you know, that you believe in that. But the best thing, I think, you have to explain to them on that stage. I don't celebrate Christmas. And
this is your choice.
Yeah.
But the scholars of Islam, they have discussed this. They use the hadith, the Athar from Ali, that was brought from the Persian, from the Ibn Abdullah Persian,
yeah.
Who were fellow worship at that time, the Jews. They sent him food or something in the Nowruz, during the Nowruz, which is a day for salvation. So he accepted. He accepted the gift. Of course, to accept the gift is something, and to celebrate is something. So due to this action, many of the scholars, they are in favor to accept the gift as long as it's not something which is, it's not, you know, a food. I'm talking about meat, literally. Slaughtered for the purpose of this day. They slaughter something, an animal, for the Christmas, and you eat it, like carefully, they use it for the purpose of the Christmas. If they are slaughtering for that purpose, then it will be considered madhubah and Muslim, because it's being slaughtered for the idols. Yeah? But if it's the general slaughtering, we know that that was a very different thing in the way for the food of the people of the world in this country. But the point is that to accept the food, if it's not related, if it's not being slaughtered for the purpose of that. But the general food, which is vegetarian or chocolate or something, By news, because you want them as an engineer, you may approach them and give them something. That's all. Related to the victim, when the victim, for example, is a university or something like that. Now, what he should do about that? He is going to be trying to be ready, you know, to approach him and say, thank you for your kindness. It's not thank you for the work, but so he's going to be kind. We thank him for his kindness. And as you go and speak to him, by the way, the Muslims will do something, you know, and thank you for, you know, the approach. That's a fact. Not thank you for the word, but thank you for the kindness of the person. Because he wants you to be kind, to say to you something for that day. But it's important for you to explain. And this was the scholars, that was the scholar, especially for people who are living in the West, in order for you to bring them. Rather than, if you didn't respond, you might feel offended. And if you respond to say yes, and do you this or whatever, then you will feel that you are leaving them. So that's why, to defend them for their approach, for the kind that they want to be, at the same time, you explain to them the importance of them, always, whatever happens, you have to address. Then this is important. So at least there will no misunderstanding that you said they will be restrained. So if I will lose the rate, thank you, I accept your gift, it's fine, it's okay. No. And at the same time, the important thing is that the Muslims and the Muslims don't believe because they don't believe because one thing is that they don't believe. That's all. Any other question?
This was one of the things.
Yeah. Who is considered as one? It is not forbidden to you. That's not true. Even though whatever he says, I know some scholar who says it's okay to say it, but actually it's the understanding is very severe. Because you give them a lot, but you give them a lot something about the word of Allah. That's your hand. That's not the issue. And Allah says in the Quran, the celebration of the disbeliever. So by you just only being there in the celebration for Christmas, I think you are with him. Yeah, it's not the same. The ship, and you are.
وياك الله يبارك فيك جزاك
الله
خير
الله يحفظك
سلام كيف حالك ان شاء الله
Otherwise, the shop will be not closed.